Welcome to this episode of ACG's Growth TV. I'm Carolyn Vallejo, and I'm here today with Justin Daniels, who's shareholder at Baker Donelson. He's here with us to talk about cybersecurity and how important it is for businesses when they plan an exit. So, Justin, everybody knows that cybersecurity is immensely important, but for companies that are looking to exit, when they're really putting it into practice, how much of a priority is cybersecurity?
So I thought the best way to talk about this is, let's peel the clock back to New Year's Eve, and we all have a resolution. I'm gonna eat differently next year. I'm going to exercise more. But things happen, life intervenes, and you kind of don't get around to doing what you said you were gonna do. That's kind of like cybersecurity. A lot of people are talking about, yes, we need to care about that, but when it comes to actually doing the things that we need to do, all you have to do is read the newspaper headlines, and you can see that there seems to be a gap between what we're saying and what is actually happening, and unfortunately, that continues to be the case.
Mm-hmm. I had a feeling you were going to say something like that. So in order to kind of convince firms to really take this seriously, you know, what are some of the potential consequences for sellers if they choose not to prioritize cybersecurity before an exit?
So this year we're going through some really interesting regulatory developments. We had the Biden executive order this year. We had a ruling from CISA, which is the Department of Homeland Security's division all about cyber. Now we have SEC regulations that are coming out around cyber disclosures for publicly traded companies. So one way we are evolving is there's going to start to be more regulatory consequences from those three-letter agencies who may regulate certain businesses and the SEC now in general. So that's one place. The reputational harm that is now coming from cyber, for example, all of us here, we're customers. And there's now more evidence that, hey, do you want to do business with certain companies if they don't care about your data, they don't demonstrate to you that they care about your privacy and security? That is going up. There are certain tech companies that have been in the news for that a lot recently, and that is becoming more prevalent. Because we now live in a society where the most important resource is data. So how we collect that data, how we secure that data becomes more important. And now the other thing we're starting to see, because we haven't had any federal overarching privacy or cybersecurity law, there's now four states who have privacy laws: California, Virginia, Colorado, and now Utah. And now there's 20 more of those laws that are being looked at by various state legislatures. So now you're having this regulatory framework come about that is legally requiring that companies care more about cybersecurity.
Mm-hmm. So say, for example, a company, you know, really is taking this seriously, really wants to prioritize cybersecurity as they plan an exit. For smaller and mid-market companies, even if they want to, they might not necessarily have all the resources they want to have in order to do so. Could you offer a little bit of advice or offer some tips for smaller and mid-sized companies that really want to take this seriously?
Sure. I think the first thing that you can do is, there's a three-stool for cybersecurity. There's people, process, and your tools.
Yeah.
Well, people, us, are sometimes the biggest impediment to good cybersecurity. There are all kinds of great tools for training your employees that don't cost a lot of money, because the number one method of cyber attack is still people clicking on emails that they shouldn't. And a lot of that is educating employees to take that extra second to look at an email that comes in saying, hey, boy, if you go to this ACG event, we're going to offer you a free, you know, gift card. When people are offering you things like that, that should already be a red flag. So people in training with software tools, that some of which are free, that's all out there. Mm-hmm. The second thing, splurge a little bit extra on the Microsoft license that allows you to enable multi-factor authentication. It is the number one thing that you can do to increase your cybersecurity hygiene at the lowest cost. Mm-hmm. Nothing is foolproof, but you can do that. It's like putting on the seatbelt in your car. It can't completely prevent something bad from happening, but it goes a long way to protecting you if something does. And then last but not least, most companies can't afford to hire a chief information security officer. So that's where being thoughtful about some third parties, and there's a whole industry around this, who can help you with your cybersecurity and can charge a reasonable price. So if you do those three things as a small to medium-sized business, you will be ahead of the curve when it comes to cybersecurity.
Mm-hmm. Got it. Those are great tips. So maybe it's not as daunting as some might seem.
It can appear that way because it's like a risk that we can't see. If we're on the road, you see the other cars, but with cyber and whatnot, it's kind of out there, but it's harder to see, and sometimes it can be technical, and that can give people pause.
Mm-hmm. Got it. Well, Justin, thank you so much for being here today and sharing that advice.
Yeah, thanks for having me.
Absolutely. My name is Carolyn Vallejo, and thank you so much for watching Growth TV.